Morning and welcome to Little by Little, a short time in God's Word. Turn with me again to Matthew chapter 24. Jesus left the temple and was going away, when his disciples came to point out to him the buildings of the temple. And he answered them, "You see all these, do you not? Truly I say to you, there will not be left here one stone upon another that will not be thrown down." As he sat on the Mount of Olives, the disciples came to him privately, saying, "Tell us, when will these things be? What will be the sign of your coming and of the end of the age?" And Jesus answered them, "See that no one leads you astray. Many will come in my name, saying, 'I am the Christ,' and they will lead many astray. And you will hear of wars and rumors of wars. See that you are not alarmed. This must take place, but the end is not yet. Nation will rise against nation, kingdom against kingdom, and there will be famines and earthquakes in various places. All these are but the beginning of the birth pains. Then they will deliver you up to tribulation and put you to death, and you will be hated by all nations for my name's sake. And then many will fall away and betray one another and hate one another. Many false prophets will arise and lead many astray. And because lawlessness will be increased, the love of many will grow cold. But the one who endures to the end will be saved. And the gospel of the kingdom will be preached throughout all the world as a testimony to all nations. And then the end will come." Maybe the disciples are wishing they didn't ask the question, right? As Jesus says, "Oh, the wars and the earthquakes and the famines, that's the beginning of the birth pains. And then, guess what's going to happen? You're going to be persecuted and even put to death." Which, as we know, is actually true for the disciples, for most of them. And throughout history, it's been true. But the intensity and severity of what this is talking about is still yet to come. And he says, "And you'll be hated by," notice, "not just by people, but by nations for the sake of Christ." And so anytime you start to see nations come up against Christians, that's a good sign. It's one of the signs that things are going in the wrong direction, away from the things of God, but God's still firmly in control. So because of this persecution, many will fall away, and then they'll betray others. And through this, false prophets will rise, and they'll lead others astray. The need leading to the end and throughout all history is for solid Bible, not just knowledge and understanding, but application in and through our lives. For Bible teaching, we need to know what the Word of God says, so we're not led astray, so we're not deceived, and so false prophets don't come up and we don't just go with them. We go, "Wait, that doesn't seem right," because, and we can look at the Word of God. The love of many will grow cold. That's a sad kind of statement. It speaks to those that kind of are part of the body, but you wonder, and then as circumstances change, they kind of fade and fall away. Where's the hope in all this? Well, verse 13, "The one who endures to the end will be saved, and the gospel will be proclaimed." Right? It's going to go out. The word will go out. And so, for us today, right now, keep looking at circumstances, at your problems, at life through the lens of Scripture, with an eye to heaven and with a resolve to follow no matter what. Till next time, a little by little.